And do you know what happens when an appraisal comes in short? Do you know what your options are, whether you're a buyer or a seller? And are you prepared for how to adjust and take the next appropriate steps? Well, stay tuned because I'm about to share that with you. Welcome to Let's Get Frank About Real Estate. I'm Frank McManus with LaMacchia Realty. And today I want to help you understand what an appraisal is and why it's important, since this is one of those emotional triggers for a lot of you during the buying or the selling emotional roller coaster that you're going to experience. Now, first thing to understand is that the appraisal is ordered by a lender and carried out by a third party who's going to actually review the property in question versus what similar types of homes have sold for, typically within about a half a mile or so of the home and within the last 3 to 6 months. This is actually being done because the lender is wanting to make sure that the home you're buying is valued at equal to or greater than the agreed upon sales price, since this is going to determine how much the lender will actually provide the loan for. Okay, fortunately, we have not had many appraisal issues here in Massachusetts to deal with. However, if you do find yourself in this situation, are you prepared of what your options are, either as a buyer or a seller? Okay, should you experience this as a seller, there's a couple of scenarios that you should actually be aware of. Number one is the actually adjusting the sale price down to the appraised value on record. Two, you can cover the discrepancy or the delta between the sales price and the appraised value by bringing that amount of cash to the closing table. Or three, you can talk to the buyer and agree to split the difference with them at the closing table. If, on the other hand, you're on the buying side, your options are somewhat similar. You as well could either cover the full difference by bringing that cash needed to the closing table. Again, number two, you can talk to the seller and come up with splitting the difference with them. Or number three, you can walk away from the deal since the lender will only provide you with the loan for the appraised value and not the full sale price. Now, obviously, depending on your financial situation, the level of love you have for the home, the time of year, the competitive nature of the market in that time of year, these are all variables that will help you determine which choice you decide and pursue to negotiate. Just make sure that whichever one it is, you are going to be completely confident and completely comfortable and can sleep easy once you've made the decision. So as always, I hope this does help you. And for more videos like these, make sure you subscribe to my Facebook, my Instagram, and my YouTube pages. Until next time.